When the first Elgeyo Marakwet County Assembly was constituted following the introduction of devolution in Kenya, the men and women tasked with oversight, representation and legislature in this county of champions knew too well the burden on their shoulders. The assembly comprises of 20 elected members and 10 who are nominated under the leadership of the speaker and professional staff who serve under the guidance of the clerk to the assembly. Their job was clearly cut out and was to ensure that the house discharges its constitutional mandate as per the expectations of the electorate. One of the immediate tasks included setting up of firm foundational systems and structures of the new county assembly.
A lot has happened, and the assembly has achieved much. Since we were elected, being the first assembly,
I have the privilege to be the first elected speaker of Elgeyo Marakwet County. Saturday we had to lay the foundation in everything. Remember that we are coming from the former local councils. And so my task as the Speaker of the House was one is to be able to bring the assembly to a parliamentary status.
The assembly also set up a county assembly service board whose role is to supervise and formulate operational policies that guide the house in the discharge of its overall mandate.
Another challenge that I had was to ensure that we put up the board.
The main aim of the office of the public member is to ensure that there is fairness. I represent the public, the whole public of Elgeyo Marakwet County. That is constituted by the four sub-counties, that is Keiyo North, where we are sitting now, Keiyo South, Marakwet East and Marakwet West. So while we were creating the offices, the office of the public member ensures that we have fairness and balance and gender is taken care of when we are doing the recruitment.
The assembly inherited assets and staff from the defunct Keiyo and Marakwet local authorities, and this had to be realigned to fit the new county assembly structure.
A strategic plan where we've provided for the administration block. This strategic plan actually is from 2013 to 2017. It's a 5-year strategic plan where we have also put down how we intend to do capacity building, how we intend to empower the members to do their legislative work, how we intend to empower members to do their oversight role, and how we intend to raise funds to be able to meet this strategic plan.
We are to ensure that we have adequate, competent staff. You will agree with me that we were using the former Iten Council Hall. We never had committee rooms. We never had modern, staff offices. We never had a lounge. We never had several other facilities. So one of the things that we had to be more deliberate as a board is to ensure that one is we ensure that there are physical structures that is able to help us in facilitation.
Other staff employed at the assembly were competitively recruited to ensure their competencies suited the needs of the house in offering professional support to members.
I take note that The Elgeyo Marakwet County Assembly is among the first assemblies to ensure that we professionalize our county assembly staff.
The journey to establish a fully fledged assembly was no easy task, and it required support from partners in building the capacity of members and staff through various training.
Again, I want to thank CPST, Center for Parliamentary Study Training, led by Professor Nyokabi. That is one body that has helped us to build and to train the members of committees in the assembly. We had to ensure that we get the best knowledge. And if you look at it critically, if you look at the level of consultants, by the way, that the assembly has been engaging, we are talking